Hola mi amigos, Olivia here, and you're watching Health Before Travel, the channel that helps you to stop and think about your health and safety before your next trip. So I'm just returning from the Canadian consulate here in the Dominican Republic, and I just wanted to pass on my own personal experience as to what happened to me over the last couple of days. So my passport, it got water damage, and because of that, my picture got altered and obviously not able to use that in order to get out of the country. So I'm just going to take you through the steps so that if this ever happens to you, you will be a little bit more in the know. So the first and foremost thing that you must do is contact your airlines company and or travel agency. Well, we just happen to have one here in the lobby with Sunwing, and they are actually the travel agency. Now they're going to be your first line of information and getting you in touch with the correct person, as well as, you know, what the steps are to do. Luckily, I am here traveling with my friends, and so four of them came with me today. But that's key. That is absolutely key that you do have somebody go with you who actually has a Canadian passport, and they must bring that with them. They are going to be your guarantor that they know you and they can validate who you are. So I was lucky enough to have four people. Didn't need four passports, just one, but you know, just good to know. The next thing when you get there is that you will need two photo IDs and current passport photo IDs. So we had an excellent taxi driver who took us directly to the location and came inside with us. And he was there and great because he was able to facilitate and help out where necessary. And in this case, of course, where's the nearest photo place? When we got there, of course, they don't speak English, so he was able to help translate for us, and they only take pesos, so he was able to help out again there. So it's really good if you just have like a lot of people who are sort of like helping you out. The more the merrier. It's definitely going to make this whole experience a lot more easier and pain-free. So once you're there, you've got a lot of forms to fill out, as this is just going to be a temporary passport that's going to get you out of the country. Once you've filled out all the paperwork and your picture and you've paid them, then now they send that off to their head office, wherever that happens to be. And in my case, it happens to be in Santo Domingo. And so I have to wait a minimum of 48 hours until I can actually get that. Luckily, I am not leaving for the next 96 hours, and so I should get that passport back before I leave here on the Tuesday before my flight leaves in the afternoon, I hope. So I really just wanted to pass on that experience for you. So first and foremost, I really sincerely hope that this never ever happens to you. Good advice, put your passport in a Ziploc bag so that it is water safe, so that doesn't happen. And of course, always keep that passport secure and safe, locked in a safe, whatever it is, just so that it doesn't get lost, so that it doesn't get damaged, so that it doesn't get stolen. Whatever it is, that passport is, as they so eloquently put, first your health, second your passport. These are the two most important things that you need to travel with at all times, okay? If you found the information that I've given you here today extremely helpful, please consider subscribing to this channel, as well as, don't forget, share this information with your own social network as well, so that they can also learn from these experiences. In the meantime, I'm going to go and have a mojito, and I would like to say I will see you again next week. Take care and have yourself a wonderful day. Bye. Hola, so today is the day I'm going home, and I actually went to the passport consulate office this morning and I picked up my document. Not a great picture, you're not allowed to smile, but picked it up today. And so yes, I will be returning to Canada on my scheduled day. So the whole process from beginning to end was not too bad. I took it in on a Friday, today is Tuesday. It was first thing in the morning and it had been returned to me. So I can go home. However, once I get to Canada, this piece of paper stays with them and I have to reapply for my passport again. However, the whole process, as long as you get it done and get it started as quickly as possible, hopefully everything works out for you if this should ever, ever happen to you. So anyways, don't forget, my final tip is just remember, when you're traveling to, put your passport in a Ziploc waterproof bag, okay? And With that, I am going to be vacating. Hasta mañana. Mwah.